In the early hours of October 7th, 1998, in Laramie, Wyoming, a senseless act of hate led to the death of a young man with a promising future. His death affected the nation and the world.
Police say Shepherd was lured from this Laramie night spot. He was later robbed, beaten, and left for dead, tied to this fence post outside of town.
The first reports of Matt's attack started showing up Thursday night on some of the Denver stations, and it was reported as a gay bashing or a possible hate crime.
When we saw him, it was like he didn't even look like Matt. He had stitches all over his face, and he was swollen, and bandages all over his head, and
he was basically begging. He was asking them to stop hitting him, telling them that they were hurting him, not to hurt him anymore.
We didn't want him to feel the trauma of the whole thing, so we played his favorite music. We sprayed his cologne around the room.
Early this morning, freshman Matthew Shepherd died from injuries he received in a vicious beating.
Authorities charged two men, Aaron McKinney and Russell Henderson, with Shepherd's murder.
Dennis said, just leave me in a room with them alone for 10 minutes and I'll take care of the whole thing. Of course, we knew we couldn't do that.
The only place that he didn't have any blood on him on his face was what appeared to be where he'd been crying down his face.
None of it made any sense to us. The degree of violence was just, it was horrific. Later, we came to understand that when it's a hate crime, this is a definite signal of a hate crime, that level of violence.
To honor Matthew's dreams, beliefs, and aspirations to make a difference in the world, Dennis and Judy Shepherd created the Matthew Shepherd Foundation. The foundation seeks to replace hate with understanding, compassion, and acceptance through its educational outreach and advocacy programs. The foundation's Erase Hate Project is the heart of the organization's work and mission. As part of this goal, Judy has spoken to over 1 million people at colleges, corporations, and religious institutions throughout the country and the world about the need to make schools and communities more accepting of everyone. Judy and Dennis continue to take their message to erase hate to the airwaves through public service announcements and television interviews.
We had a meeting and we just knew that if we went down that road of anger and hate, that we'd be victims too. And I wasn't going to give anybody that kind of power.
The Matthew Shepherd Foundation has been at the forefront of the effort for congressional passage of the federal hate crimes legislation known as the Matthew Shepherd Act.
If we can find the strength and courage to stand up and speak out against hate crimes, then Congress ought to have the same strength and courage.
Judy and the Foundation's advocacy were instrumental in the recent historic passage of the Matthew Shepherd Act in both the United States House of Representatives and Senate.
This is a very simply stated, as Mrs. Shepherd has pointed out, that we do not want to have second-class citizens in the United States of America.
This law, symbolic as it is, can change hearts and minds and can be real substance.
It is stories, true human stories, that drive change. And Matthew Shepherd's is one of the most profound of all.
One way that the project supports GLBTQ youth is through MatthewsPlace.com. This comprehensive online village is a safe place full of critical resources and information. A place where GLBTQ youth can see themselves reflected in our society, feel affirmation, and gain insights to help them lead healthy, productive, hate-free lives. Through its homeless and disenfranchised youth program, the foundation is committed to ensuring that GLBTQ youth are safe, valued, and respected. GLBTQ youth are being driven to the streets at an unacceptable rate. This program seeks to raise public awareness about the reality facing these young people and engage individuals and direct service providers to help GLBTQ youth build healthy and successful lives. The Foundation's Equality Project seeks to ensure gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender equality by focusing on getting members of the GLBT and allied community to vote with initiatives like its aggressive 2006 Get Out the Vote campaign and through its civil rights program that supports legislation that impacts the GLBT community.
You don't have to like us, you don't have to believe in it, you just have to respect that under the Constitution, and when it comes to civil rights and benefits, we are all equal under the law, or we live in a different kind of country than the one we think we do.
When you have a foundation like the Matthew Shepard Foundation, you have a leader like Judy and a leader like Dennis, and you have the opportunity to say, we're going to keep putting the spotlight on this until everybody pays attention. We will call this what it is, and it is hate, pure and simple.
My long-term goal is that it isn't needed anymore, that the gay community is no longer separated from everybody else as the gay community, where everything is equal, where it's a totally accepting society on every avenue.
Someday, the fight to erase hate will be a memory. Until then, the Matthew Shepard Foundation will help lead the way.